I think the goal was to just empower women and female athletes worldwide to have that support from hundreds of females who have a dream, who have a goal, and who want equality, who want the equal rights, who just want the same respect as the male athletes and males in general. I think just having the female support and the empowerment we have in one another to support each other through the sport, through the movement, I think that was something unique, that was something very special. And for us as teenagers, for us as females in general, and for us through the movement, I think that's what would impact a lot of girls our age or younger, or the next generation athletes and females in general, to keep it going, to keep going with the movement, to just keep going with their dreams and just keep it alive. I think having the support from friends and families that are hours away and just doing this for us, that, you know, who have the same ambitions in life, who have the same meaning, and who just want the same thing as I do and other athletes, I think that's what goes a long way.
The way she wants to empower women and the youth, essentially, is very... it's great, you know, I support her 100%. I think that it's one of the best things that someone so young like me can do. And, you know, she motivates me all day, every day, every second, every time. Every time I talk to her, she motivates me to keep pushing. Although I'm not near her. I wish I was, but she pushes me. She encourages me. She doesn't let me get down. And I'm never going to forget, every time I'm stressed, she's like, don't be stressed, just eat a cupcake. And that's like my line with her. Like, I, you know, like, she does it, I'm pretty sure she like says it all the time, but like I remember her because of that.
Lucetta's always had really good work ethic. She's hardworking, she's dedicated, and when she puts her mind to something, she'll go above and beyond to achieve her goals. She'll do whatever it takes. She knows that nothing's gonna be given to her. She has to work hard to achieve anything. And it's really good that she's always been like that.
Hi, I'm Yusette Dia. I'm Bella. I'm here to answer some questions for the documentary. So yeah. One of the questions was, what do you have to say about Yusette trying to empower women? Well, I think it's an amazing and wonderful thing what Yusette is doing. I know that every time I see her post or anything, she inspires and motivates me to be the best version of myself. And I think it's wonderful and amazing because I think it takes a really strong and, you know, inspiring individual to do that for other people. And I think it's just amazing. And I always text her. I'm like, you inspire me. I'm like, I'm so proud of you. I'm like, I send her pictures of me going to the gym. I'm like, I'm at the gym. I'm like, you motivated me to be here.
About yourself, empowering women. I think it's truly amazing. And like, she's doing such a good job. Like the Zooms we've done were great, like the topics we talked about were very important, and it was really like, felt really good to normalize and just talk about it with each other since we've all been through it and we all understand everything about it. And I feel like that was very important because sometimes you feel like that it's not normal, but it is. It's just nobody talks about it because, you know, you don't want to be judged or something like that. And I feel that it was very important for her to start something like this, and it's just great overall.
But I think what she's trying to do is something really strong. It's something really powerful. It's something that, you know, not a lot of girls athletes can do. It's something that takes time and patience. It's something that takes dedication, because at the end of the day, you know, that's what it is. It's coming together as a whole and being dedicated to something like this, and that's what's going to motivate more girls to continue on their athletic journey, more girls to continue on their journey towards, it doesn't have to be sports, it could be sports, careers, because like a person like I'm not going to focus on sports after high school. I'm going to go into equality, and it comes with equality within the youth. We call equality between a woman and a guy, equality between all races, equality between the economy. It comes with platforms, and I think that woman empowering women is a great aspect that she can contribute and she can keep on going. So I'm really, really proud of her, and thank you all for letting me be a part of this. I really enjoy being with Giselle and talking to Giselle and, you know, contributing with anything that Giselle is putting her heart into. So yeah.
Hi, my name's Carissa. I've known Isel for 4 years, and I first met her my 8th grade year. I saw her on someone's Snapchat, and I asked that person like who she was, and they gave me her Snapchat, and then I started texting her, and that's where it all started, basically. I met her in person my 8th grade year. I want to say almost like right before summer.
Hi, I'm dealing with Dehano, and I'm one of Isel's closest friends, and she's also my wrestling partner. How is Isel as a wrestler? Isel's always very interesting. She just made it one of her priorities for herself. You could walk into practice any day, and you could just tell she has her whole heart in the sport. The love and passion she has for wrestling is what makes her an amazing wrestler. She never complains, she never argues, she never gives attitude. She would step into the mat with the beast energy and the best attitude. She could have had the worst day ever at school, and she'll give nothing but 110% on the mat.
Out of her, and I already told her that, like, you know, she inspires me. The next question was, best memory of Isel? Well, since we grew up so close in age, I'm only 11 months older, I would think. I assume I could be wrong. My math could be way off, but I'm pretty sure I'm 11 months older. Since we grew up so close in age, there is a lot of memories of us. But I think the first thing that comes to mind is when I have a girls' day. So basically, I would go pick up all my nieces, Isel, Janessa, and June, and we would all go down to the mall and go shopping and just talk about our lives and catch up and give each other advice. And like, it was just really great, and I really loved it. And we used to go eat, and it was always a good time. And I think that's one of my best memories of Isel and my niece. What do you have to say about Isel as she's always trying to do more in her life as a person? Well, I think that, you know, like I said before, she inspires and motivates me as well. So I think in seeing that and seeing her grow up and, you know, grow up into this amazing and wonderful person that motivates their people and just like is always out there trying to do their best and trying to develop as a person, it's just very motivating.
How would I describe Isel? Well, for starters, good thing the question isn't how would you describe Isel in one word, because there's no way you can describe an amazing athlete or even an incredible person in general in just one word. So how would I describe Isel? I would describe Isel as a passionate athlete. She's someone who always shows dedication. She never gives up on anything. You can tell Isel, no, you can't do something. It's impossible. And the next time you see her, she'll smile directly at you while she does exactly what you told her she couldn't do. She's someone who will see someone struggling and she'll rush over and help you until you meet your goal. To sum up this question's answer, she's the perfect wrestling partner.
I would describe Isel as such a good person. Like, if you guys don't know Isel, I feel so bad for you, because she's just such a great person, like, overall. Like, I wish there was more people like her in the world. She has the biggest heart ever, such a big heart, and she's so supportive of everything, like, of your choices, of like what you want to do in life. And she's such like a humble person. Like, nowadays you don't meet a lot of humble people, but like, she for sure is one of the most humble, big-hearted people I know to this day. She's very athletic. I remember when I first met her, she played basketball. It was her first year on varsity basketball and at our high school. And I remember going to go see her play, and I was like, oh my gosh, like, she's so good. And she's super athletic. Like, she's just very natural, like a natural athlete. I think that's one thing, like, she has very good going for her. I'd also describe her as just super energetic. She's always loud, and she like does so much in such a little time. Like, she does so much, and she's just so like self-driven. It's crazy. Like, I don't think I've ever met someone that's been that much like dedicated to a sport. And just her, with all that dedication and love and passion that she has for all the sports that she plays, like, that's definitely gonna get her places. Like, anywhere she wants to go, she can do it, and I know she can. And like, if you think she can't do it, like, she's gonna go out there and make it her mission to prove you wrong, and she will prove you wrong. Like, that's just how Isel is. She's very self-driven, very self-motivated. She's so dedicated to her sports and everything that she does. Like, she's gonna do it 100% and give it all that she has. Like, even if she doesn't have any more left, like, she's just so self-driven that she's gonna give you everything like she has 100% always, all the time, no matter what she's doing, no matter how tired she is. Like, she doesn't let it affect her at all. She's just so self-motivated and so self-driven that she just can do anything she wants. Whatever she sets her mind to, like, she can do it. And if you think she can do it, like, she's gonna go out, make it her mission, and prove you wrong. Like, without a doubt, she's gonna prove you wrong.
What did I think about Yisel when she first started wrestling? My first thought when Yisel started wrestling was, it's about time she got onto the mats. Since the day I first met Yisel, I knew she would be a great athlete. My junior year of high school, I talked to Yisel about wrestling because I just knew she had the skill and talent for it. Plus, she's basically nothing but muscle, so it just made sense for Yisel to be a wrestler. Why did I always push Yisel to wrestle? I always push Yisel to wrestle because, as I mentioned before, you could just look at her and tell she wrestles. It wouldn't make sense for an athlete named Yisel Arias not to wrestle. I played basketball with Yisel since 7th grade, and when I started wrestling, I talked to Yisel about it, and I knew I just had to get her on the mat. She literally comes from a family with 4 brothers, who, if I'm not mistaken, they all wrestle. It was just a matter of time until Yisel became a wrestler herself. I'm so grateful she started wrestling because she would also push me to never quit and to never give up. And I'll always be thankful for her for that. So why did I push Yisel to wrestle? Well, because I knew she'd make one awesome partner and an even better wrestler.
I think some of my favorite moments that have to do with Yisel would be all the time during my games. Throughout quarters, halftime, after the game, I could see Yisel in the stands and she's just staring at me, like this deathly stare, and just was focused on me. And then she'd smile and she'd give me a thumbs up, or afterwards she'd tell me I did a great job. And she'd make fun of me because I'm so small and I'd have to like fight people on the floor for a ball. And she'd start laughing at me. And it just like made me feel like I had a great game and like I really did something. There's a time she fell off a chair. We were in coach's office and Yisel's just sitting there like a normal human. And then we all turn for 1 second, we look at her, and she fell. She just fell off the chair. She screamed, "Oh my God," just like that, fell, hit the floor, and starts dying, laughing. And now we all pick on her because she can't even sit in a chair right. She can't.
Best wrestling memory with Yisel. If I wanted to, I could make a whole album of memories with Yisel and I, but if I had to choose just one to be the best, I'd have to go with her first day of practice. Why? Because as soon as she walked in and got warmed up, she came up to me and said, "Hey, let's be partners." For that whole practice, we never switched partners. And from then on, we became partners, not only for a while, but for the season. Actually, no, we became partners for the sport. We would walk into the wrestling room together, we would warm up together, we would practice together, and we would leave together. So if I had to choose only one memory to be my favorite with me and Yisel, it's the day Yisel became my wrestling partner.
I would say my favorite memory with Yisel, out of all the crazy memories we have, I have to say my birthday, for sure, without a doubt. Okay, it was summer, and during this time Yisel was playing basketball year round, I think, I'm pretty sure. And she had practice the day of my birthday, and I just wanted to spend time with her for my birthday. That's all I wanted for my birthday. And so I went to her practice, and I know her coaches. Were coaches at the time, and so they were just cool with me staying there watching them practice. And I was just waiting for her to get done with practice and stuff, and then afterwards me, her, and like a group of our mutual friends, her mom picked us up, Yisel's mom picked us up, shout out to Yisel's mom, and we all got pizza. I don't know, we just got pizza, and we went to Yisel's house and we just all hung out, ate pizza, talked, you know, just in each other's presence, enjoying each other's presence. And then towards the end, everyone got in the pool and they had just gone out of practice. I was wearing like my birthday fit and they literally got into the pool. And I think I was the only one who didn't go in the pool at that time. And that was my first time ever meeting Yisel's mom. I met her once again after that, and her grandma. I love her grandma so much. Okay, that's irrelevant. But she they sang happy birthday to me. I want to say they brought me a cake, like a little piece of cake, or yeah, I want to say they brought me a cake or something. I don't know, but they sang happy birthday to me, which I thought was so sweet because I was so nervous of being her mom, and she literally sang happy birthday to me. And I remember that day just being so happy, like just being so happy I got to spend it with Isel, like me and her mom and stuff. And then we just got to spend it with our friends, and it was just a really good time overall. And I would for sure have to say that's my favorite memory of us in the book of our memories.
During this pandemic, Isel has been a really big team player in our family. She's been going above and beyond in the house. Things that she doesn't have to do, she achieves them and she does them without us even having to ask her. And she's really held down the fort with the kids and with everybody. She's been a really good support system for everyone. So I'm really proud of her, and I really feel really good at the person she's becoming. Even though this is hard for everybody, she still strives to be positive throughout this time and keep busy all the time.
Not a lot of people, you know, get to or even motivate people. So I mean, the fact that I get to do that, I think that's amazing. I hope you enjoyed the journey. I hope you enjoyed little glimpse of my life. It's not always sunny, it's not always good, it's not always the best, especially during this hard time. But I can't complain because I'm very grateful and thankful that I have what I have. You know, even though opportunities were gone, it sucks, it pisses me off. It's not fair that a lot of other people and athletes get to go out and still do what they love.
And her drive, she's super driven, like by herself, like self-motivated. And I think that's something that a lot of people need. And she's one of those people that has it, and she's the type of person that she has so much of it inside her that she literally gives it to you. Like, she gives you that much support, that much like pushing you and stuff, that it makes you want to do it yourself. She's super like impacting on people and stuff, and I think that's also like a super good thing she has going for her. I would describe herself also as very shy but loud at the same time. When I first met Isel, she was so shy. Like, she's literally like a little girl, so shy. But once you get to know her and stuff, she's so loud. She literally doesn't shut up.
I like to dance after my workouts. Today was a good workout, but I think I'm gonna run more. So here we go. So if you didn't get my message earlier,
work out
and dance. Dance your stress away, dance what you need to let go. Hey, yeah, we have this on repeat, but you know why?
That's not even a bad thing, like actually it's not a bad thing, but she's just super loud, and I think that honestly helps her a lot on the court. Like, she's very vocal, she's good at communicating. But yeah, I would just describe yourself as such a big kind-hearted girl. Like, she truly deserves the best in life, and she's gonna go places, I know for sure.
Making this documentary was something I've always wanted to do. I know it might be not as great as others, but going back from the start of this pandemic, I never really thought it was going to be this life-changing. You really had to deep into yourself. You really had to keep yourself motivated as an individual. You really had to keep getting out of bed every morning. You had to make your new goals. My new goals this quarantine was to read a lot of books, run quite a few marathons, and make this documentary. A lot of people were very interested in how I live my life. But there's not a lot of sunshine days, there's not a lot of happy days, especially in the sad world. There's times when you don't feel motivated, when you feel like it just sucks so much that you wish you could just like run away, or you wish you could wake up from this bad nightmare. But I want everyone to motivate each other. Not everyone's gonna care about your dreams. Not everyone's gonna support you. So just make it happen. Be that sunshine in someone's day. Call that someone, call that person, call your family, check up on your family, because you may never know when it's gonna be your last or their last. It took us a whole pandemic to realize what we took for granted. Going out all the time, going to parties, going to family events. Sucks. I don't know how many people are going to look at this and feel motivated, inspired, whatever. All I'm going to say is, if you want to do a documentary, you want to run a marathon, you want to be still in sunshine, you want to keep going, you want to lose weight, you want to gain muscle, you want to read a book, you want to make a book, you want to run a marathon, you want to make a difference in the world, do it. Do it. Not a lot of people live. And live every day like it's your last. Check up on people. Be the positivity. Be the positive. Be the smile that brightens everyone's day. Be that person. Because not everyone is. I try to be that every day. You don't want to fail as a cousin. You don't want to fail as a daughter. You don't want to fail as a friend. A best friend. A family member. You don't want to fail. You don't. This pandemic has tested us all. Tested me. Broke me. It sucks. I'm not gonna sit here and lie to you that it doesn't. It sucks. It's sad. But we still have hope. We're still positive. We still get to FaceTime the people we love. And you should never take that for granted. Go out there and be the change. Do what you love. Love what you do. I'm talking to you. I'm not talking to the camera right now. This will not be the last documentary. Be the alpha. Lead. Have no goals. Never give up. Sacrifice. Never lose motivation. Never lose hope. You want to be an Olympic champ? Make it happen. You want to be the best nurse out there? Make it happen. You want to be a police officer? Make it happen. You want to be the first girl in the NBA? You want to be the first girl to be the president of the United States? Make it happen. I miss my family so much. I miss my friends. I miss my team. I miss my basketball, wrestling team. A lot of people have a lot of opportunities and life's not fair. Life is not fair. Sometimes I think, why am I working so hard when I can't even leave my dad's house? When I can't go to wrestling practice, when I can't go to basketball practice, when I can't do certain tournaments, I can't even leave the house. And it sucks. It sucks to see people actually spending time with their family members, going to tournaments and having all these great times, but yet I can't do that. It's not fair. But, less motivation, you know. Just because we ain't out there doesn't mean we don't love our family, doesn't mean we ain't working harder to prove people wrong. No, we're using this as motivation. Once we get the opportunity, once life is back to normal, we're gonna, we're gonna make a change, we're gonna make a difference. Back to talking about the documentary. I don't know how many people are gonna see this. I don't know how many people this is gonna inspire or motivate. I'm just a small town girl with a big dream. That's it. That's to inspire, motivate, empower as many people I possibly can in my one life path. I try to live every day. Oh, man. I miss my family so much. My friends. You have no idea. Life is so sad right now. But as a daughter, as a sister, as a cousin, as a friend, a best friend, I need to check up on my people. I need to make sure they go out there and live every day. I need to make sure they have a goal, that they go out there every day with a goal and they achieve it. No matter what, the world is yours. You can do whatever you want, this side of the world. You know, look at me. I'm in my garage. I'm in my dungeon right now talking to a camera. 15 years from now, I don't know where I'm gonna be at. So work hard. Do what you love. Follow your dreams. Dream big. The world is so sad right now, but this will not last. I'm Issa Arias. That was a female. And this is my story. And that's it. Oh, we did it! We did it. We did it.